Podcast. I am Amy and I'm your host. I am podcasting today from my living room because it's gloomy and wet outside. It is episode 80 today. Today is December 26th and day after Christmas, obviously. I'm sorry I couldn't be outside, but you know, it wasn't just the weather. It was also, I have just so much stuff to show you. I am a week late with podcasting, but there's a reason for that, and I'll get into that. But thank you for watching. Thank you for taking the time to watch my podcast. I really appreciate it, and it makes me happy to do this, so you're a part of that. I got a lot to talk about, maybe a long one, but maybe I'll save some for the next podcast. I basically meant to podcast over a week ago, week before Christmas, after the senior level long, but if you checked out my Ravelry group, you'll see that I had to cancel it. So I had a rain date or snow date, if you will, which was Christmas Eve. It was the only other day they could have me. And but I will talk about the senior level along at the end and also draw the prizes for everyone that entered in the senior level along prize thread. I'm also drinking. You know what? I love this mug. But I feel like the handle should be on the other side so that the sheep shows. I'm drinking some nice hot green tea with just a little bit of honey in it. It's hitting the spot. It's not super cold out. It's like 40 degrees. That might be really cold to some of you. Sorry about the glare on my glasses. I have spotlights on me so that you could see my knitting well. And it's reflecting off my glasses, but I need them to see, so there's nothing we could do about it. Anyway, it's wet and damp outside, and I love a nice hot cup of tea when it's that kind of weather out. Don't you like that? Does that make you feel warm and snuggly, or maybe hot chocolate? So, so I will talk about the senior love along at the end of this, and I will draw the prizes at the end of this. So if you posted in the prize thread, stay tuned to the end, although I will be contacting everyone. And just on that note, while I'm talking kind of administrative, there's also the 2016 goals contest. I am going to lock that finished object thread on January 6th. So I'll give you till January 6th to post all your finished goals. And that podcast will probably be dedicated to going over what I did in 2016 and thinking about what I want to do for 2017. I'll probably do another goals contest. I'll probably make it more simple because a lot of people were confused last year, so I'll try and think of a way to make it more simple to win prizes. Alright, so I guess let's start with my whips. You see me here knitting on my Smithy socks. I've been knitting on these for a while. These are toe-up socks knit with socks that rock medium weight in the Cornucopius colorway. We picked this yarn up at two Rhinebecks ago. Marc picked out the color for himself. Socks that rock medium weight is like the perfect sock yarn for Marc. I know it's just superwash merino. I don't know if it has a nylon content, but I think the super twisted has. These socks last a long time for him because he's got rough feet. And I found that all the other socks I've knit him that haven't been socks that rock wear out really quick. Or they felt. So I love the socks that rock. They're perfect. So anyway, these are coming along. These are, like I said, these are toe up, and I've mentioned this before, but I'm not really fond of the toe up yet. I think this is like my second or third pair of toe up socks. And I just have a real hard time getting the perfect spot to start the heel gusset, or start the gusset for the heel. I have knit toe up with the fish lips kiss heel, no problem. So, it's just the gusset part, because it's so precise where you need to start, and it's hard to really kind of, you can't gauge it. You have to really calculate it, I guess. And Marc also has thick feet, if you will. So his circumference around where the heel is, the ankle, it's very thick. So he also needs more space there than most people. So, and that's why I like to do top-down socks for him. I also always do, I don't do fish lips kiss heel for him because of how big his ankle is. It just doesn't work. He doesn't fit in that nice little nook. So I always do a heel flap for him. So these are for Marc. This is the second sock. I'll show you. I'm knitting these on Haya, and I believe they're twos. So the 40 inch circulars. I'm using the size two. And of course, this is Magic Loop. This is what I knit most of my socks on. Occasionally, I like to pull out my signature double pointed and knit a pair of socks on double pointed needles. I really I enjoy it once in a while, but I can knit faster with the Magic Loop. These are in my Socks That Rock anniversary bag, which is a very nice sturdy bag. I forget who made it. Queen Bee. Here is the first sock. So you can see here, and this fits them perfect. I had them try it on. You can see how big the heel is here, right? So, again, I love the way it came out. The Smithy sock is a nice chevron pattern with garter stitch in between, so it's nice and stretchy, which is perfect too for Marc. He likes that. And I really enjoyed this pattern. I believe this is a Socks That Rock pattern. I think it came with one of the club yarns I got, but I'm not sure if it came with one of the club yarns or if I bought it. Let's see if it says so on here. She's by Shannon Squire. Doesn't say, but here, let me show you a picture. They're lovely, and it looks good with the variegated yarn, I think. Sorry about the blotch in the middle. It must have gotten wet. But yeah, I'm really enjoying these, and I bet you I will be done by the time I podcast next with this sock. I don't know if I will be doing, I'm sure I will do toe-up socks again, but I think what I need to do is, first of all, I'm going to, my next couple of pairs of socks will definitely be cuff down, my preferred method and one that I'm much more comfortable in. Excuse me, and I have been perusing my queue. I have a lot of lovely sock patterns that I want to knit up by, like, some of my favorite sock designers, like Hunter Hammerson, Alice Yu, Heatherly Walker, or Yarn Yenta, she calls herself. So many, or I don't know, do I want the next one to just be another plain vanilla? You may recall, if you've been watching me, I was doing a School of Socks knit along with Mustache Yarns. And I wasn't in love with the pattern, I didn't care for it. And it was toe up, and I just didn't like it, and I wasn't getting the gauge they were getting. I couldn't get the right gauge, so the directions on when to start the heel didn't work for me. I was thinking I might, I'm gonna definitely frog it, and I'm going to just knit plain vanilla, or maybe like, I was looking through some self-striping sock patterns, just something, just to make it a little easier, and I came across the lollipop yarn ones. If you go to the lollipop yarn web, Etsy shop, she shows her yarns knit up, and she uses this little pattern, so I got that. It's a free one, and I think I might use that for it, so just to make it a little more interesting, if you know what I mean. So that is probably the pair of socks I will do next. I am also, speaking of socks, so this is kind of a whip. It's an FO that has become a whip. I already gave one pair to my son, but my son had some holes in some socks that I have knit him, and I'm finally getting around to fixing them. One I have already fixed, and that was a pair that I made with Patton's Croy. That yarn does not wear out. I'm telling him, it does not wear out. He actually snagged it, and it kind of ripped a hole just above the ankle on the leg. And I just kind of knit a patch for it and kind of knit it to the sock. I was going to darn it. I've never actually darned a pair of socks before. That was my first time. And so I didn't do the weaving thing. I just kind of picked up some stitches, a couple of rows below where the hole is, and then a couple of rows to either side of the hole. I would kind of pick up those stitches and knit it together with the last stitch of the patch I was knitting. And then the top row, I wish I'd done it differently. What I should have done is just when I was done knitting, left all the stitches and not knit the row or bind off, but sew those stitches or graft those stitches onto the sock. I didn't think of it, but next time I have something similar, I will try that. So what I'm doing now is, let me show you, did I keep that? I have that down here. Here's one of the socks, and these are his favorite. These are, let's see what yarn this is. I forget what yarn this is. It's the Hermione Everyday Sock pattern, but I kind of changed it a little. It's a Merino Cashmere Silk Fingering Weight by Becoming Art Thea. And the colorway is Mountain Rivers. It's a delectable yarn, but let's see. I'm looking at my project page. I finished these in October of 2015, and this is what they look like already. And even like around the hole here, it's very thinned out from Joe wearing them. I know he wears them a lot, but still, that's really quick. So I guess for Joe going forward, I'll have to make sure the socks I knit him have nylon in it. But what I did basically is I just, I cut off the top and I'm re-knitting the toe part rather than darning these, just because it's very thin up here, and it's just a matter of time before the whole thing goes, so I decided to do it that way. And here's the other one. And the other thing I noticed, and don't get me wrong, I really love this yarn, and it doesn't appear that she or this person is dying anymore. I have this much left over, so I have plenty to fix it with. And the color is beautiful, and I love knitting with it, but you can also see that when I show you, what I've done so far, you can see how much the color has faded since I knit these in a year. You can see how much darker the top is. You can actually see where I Come on. Focus. Well, if I stay still, maybe it will focus. Anyway, on the top, it's much darker and the colors are more vivid. And you can see the rest of the sock, it's very faded. Here's the back. You can see it a little more pronounced there. So, a little disappointed that the color didn't stay as saturated. But yeah, that's what I'm doing with these. So even if I finish Mark's socks, I'll just finish fixing this pair for Joe. They are his favorites. I know he walks around his house with them all the time. And it's not long before the heels go. Not long. They're thin too. I'm wondering if should I duplicate stitch them before I give them back to Joe? If you have any ideas about that, you can see the heels are pretty thin too. You can see kind of how threadbare they are, especially there. I don't know. If you have darned your socks before, or if you have any ideas, please let me know. So that's another thing I'm working on. I actually just started this yesterday, Christmas Day. That's what I did. Decided to work on Joe's socks. All right, so what else have I got here on the needles? I've been working feverishly on my Torquata wrap by Ambah O'Brien. I'm sure you've seen this, and actually, if you like it, Miss Babs has a sale. Her gratitude sale is going on, 20% off everything on her shop. She get a nice gradient set with a nice contrasting color. This one I'm using is the Eucalyptus gradient set, and the color is cocoa, and it's beautiful together. I will say, be warned that this is her 133 yard gradient set minis, and I did a gauge swatch, and I had a choice between row and stitch gauge. I couldn't make both. And sometimes that happens. And what I should have done is I should have, well, I don't know if it would have mattered. Basically, I picked the fabric that I kind of liked better, which is actually a little looser. And I've run out of yarn. I'm not able to do all the repeats that the pattern calls for because I'll run out of yarn. So if you use a Miss Babs gradient set for this, make sure you do, make sure you really check your gauge. So I am on the 1, 2, 3, 4th color now. And there are 5, 6, 2 more colors to go. So the color I'm working on now, the 4th color is called Bark. And it's a beautiful little taupe color. And I think that my yellow wall in the background is kind of shifting the color a little bit. And then this was like a thyme green. And here we go, like a blue gray and a more blue. And let's see what colors. After this, I have a color called Fruit. And then after that is my favorite color of them all, called Flower, which I didn't see any single skeins with Flower. It's a little less purpley than it seems to be showing up with. It's more of a rosy pink, and it's beautiful. And here's the chocolate, the cocoa. I forget, is it chocolate or cocoa? Let me see if I can find the label for that. Cocoa is the name. And it's all yummy to ply. So I am knitting this out of my Jan Smiley bag with my frogs. I love this bag. I collect I used to collect when I was a kid. I collected anything with frogs on it. So this pattern is very easy to memorize. It's very beautiful. And even though I did kind of not have enough for all the repeats, it's fine. You can see kind of, if you look, you can see I did only the first two. Actually, it's like four rows of the little diamond, half diamonds, the triangle here. But it still looks fine. And it'll still be beautiful. If I had to do it over again, what I would have done is made it one less repeat wide. And then I bet I would have had enough, or maybe even two less repeats wide, which would have been, let's see, about 4 inches less wide. And it still would have been a beautiful wrap. But it is what it is, and I love it. I definitely would look forward to knitting more of her patterns. I have to admit, feeling very tempted to go to the Miss Babs site and maybe purchase a gradient set, but there's just no way I can justify buying yarn. And I'm still grappling over going to Vogue Knitting Live. Sandy's trying to talk me into it, and I keep saying no because I can't buy any more yarn. I got a ton of yarn for Christmas. I had tons of yarn, and I don't know where I'd put any more. But she's like, come on, we'll just spend a day in the city. We'll take my car. We'll go out for dinner. We get to see people. We'll walk around. Usually, I go down and I make a weekend of it, and we rent a room, and we stay 2 nights, and I take classes. I'm not doing any of that this year. And there were lots of great classes, but I am also going to Florida in February, so I don't know. I'm just trying to rein in on my spending as well. And I figured if I do a big yarn event, it will have to be Rhinebeck this year. And maybe, and this is a very big maybe the Maryland sheep and wool, which I've never done, if Sandy decides she wants to go. And that's a big maybe. Because like I said, I need to save some money. I got a lot of extra bills now this year because I'm starting to pay the student loans for Rachel's school, and just, it's all crazy. Anyway, let's keep going with the whips because there is more. Oh, I forgot to put the pattern in here. Let me just throw this in. All right, so next is, speaking of Rachel, I am knitting her the Glam Lamb by Stephen West. I don't have a picture printed, but that's okay. And I put a marker on this for you so you could see, because it's, you know, a very straightforward pattern. I think the marker is on the others. Oh no, here it is. Okay. So you knit it side to side, and here is an armhole, and then here I'm still working the back. This is how much I knit since I last showed you. It's not much. I've been working more on shawls than on this. This will be one of Rachel's Christmas presents next year. I don't know if I've talked about this much, but I like to knit Christmas presents early and get them out of the way. I don't like to wait until like September, October, or even later, some people start. I like to get them done in the beginning of the year and tuck them away, and there they are already. This sweater, or wrap, or whatever you want to call it, has an I-cord border, which is just lovely. I am knitting it out of Debbie Bliss Roma, which is a bulky weight, and it's lovely to knit with. I can't say enough good things about it. So this is this shawl pattern or sweater pattern, and this yarn is a big yes. And I like the pattern as well. It's very warm and snuggly. It's kind of like bunchy around your neck, and I know my daughter will love it. She actually saw it, the pattern, and said she loved it and kind of picked it out. So she's getting this for Christmas 2017. And it's humming along. When I finish this, because the deal for 2017 for me, oh, by the way, I'm knitting this on Knit Picks interchangeables. I think it's a size 13. I think this is a 13. I don't have anything that big in anything but my Knit Picks, but Hiyas are my favorite needles, but Knit Picks are great too. So, what was I saying? One of the deals that I'm going to do for 2017 is every time I finish, for every new pattern or a new cast on that I finish, I have to then complete a whip. So this has been a hibernated whip. It's in my Elizabeth Zimmerman bag, which has my name on it. Amy. Isn't that cute? And actually, you know what I think? I would sew this to the bag. I made this for when I went to sweater camp, which is Meg Swanson's knitting camp. I'd love to do that again, but I can't afford that this year either. Car payments now, all sorts of stuff. But anyway, off track. So after, this is actually was a hibernating project, and when I finished that Ready for Fall sweater, which it's already pilling a lot. I hate that. And I bought one of those brushes that the Mason-Dixon knitters brag about. I forget what they call it. And it helped a lot, but then it just pills right back up again. And I'm surprised because it's a wool silk blend, the Brigantia. But I have to, like, every time I wear it, I have to kind of get the pills off of it. Otherwise, I just love it. So after I finish this, as I was saying, I'll be able to cast on a new cast on. And I'm going to do the, I had bought right around Rhinebeck, I had bought her black cherry yarn in the, not Brigantia, but the Berte, which is her merino silk cashmere blend. Very luxurious. And I'm going to make a Mine Hill sweater, which is a kind of a cardigan by Amy Herzog. And it's a custom fit pattern. If you're not aware of her custom fit website, I put in my measurements and got the pattern customized for me. So that will be the next sweater on the needles. And I can't wait. And one last whip, and that is the Boo Knits shawl that I'm working on called Out of Darkness. Do I have a picture of that printed? I don't think so. I don't usually print the page with the pictures because of all the ink it uses. So no, I don't. And I did put a progress keeper on here so you guys can see how far I am. And of course, this is a lace weight project. And so therefore, it doesn't look the way it's going to look when it's done. Just give me a second to find the progress keeper. Okay. And it's on the wrong side. Get this around. All right, here's the right side. I am well into the lace part of the pattern. I think you can kind of see it. It's beaded, and the beads are triangular crystal beads, or glass beads, rather. And the yarn is 100% Tessa silk, and it's by Lost City Knits, and it's Lost City Silk is the name of it. And the colorway is On a Winter's Day. And if you give me a second, I've already lost the progress keeper. Come on. Where are you? Sorry. Here it is. Okay. So this is, doesn't seem like much, but it is because this is my first beaded shawl. So it's kind of slow going, especially on the rows that have beads. And I wish you could see the beads better, but they're not popping out. But so this I cast on because I want to wear it to an engagement party for one of my good friends. She's getting married in January of 2018, but her engagement party is actually January 15, 2017. So I have to finish this in 2 weeks. So I think this will be my main project. You can kind of see the beads better. This will be my main project for the next couple of weeks because I really, really want to wear it. And I figure I'll wear a black dress underneath. And yeah, like that. So this is what it looks like unblocked. I love this. I'm not a big fan of knitting with lace weight yarns. I just can't feel it, you know, and it just smells great. I love the smell of silk. But I love this pattern so much, and I love the yarn a lot. And this is what I wanted. So let me show you the bag it's in is Fat Squirrel bag from a couple of Christmases ago, and I love her bags. They're great. They're fantastic. And you know what? Let me show you the beads. Actually, you know what? I don't want to take it out. I keep the beads. stuck. All right. I keep the beads. I have a dish with beads on my desk where I do most of my knitting. But I also have this little plastic container that I keep inside the yarn, and I could just take the top off and take the beads out and then just put the top back on, and I can, so if I have the project on the go, you can see it kind of sticking out in the bottom. So that is that, and I think I've gone through all of my widths. I do have one FO, but I don't have it with me because it was a Christmas present from my mother-in-law, but it is the Muratura hat by Wooley Wormhead. She's her Cal is actually still going for this, and there's some knitter's pride prizes for it, but I gave that hat to my mother yesterday for Christmas. It was one of her presents, and I have a picture of my husband modeling it, and I'll stick that in here so you can see it. I absolutely love Wooley Wormhead's patterns, and I've never not loved a pattern of hers that I have made. So like I said, you can't go wrong with a Wooley Wormhead hat. All right, so I guess I should move it along and show you all my stash enhancement, because I got a lot of yarn for Christmas. So I'm going to try and get through this. I got some books also as well for Christmas from my husband. Kind of asked him for them. One is called Knitting from the North. Where did I see this? Knit British podcast touted this book, and The book is great. They're very simple stranded knitting projects. If you look at this book up in Ravelry, she doesn't have all the projects listed, so you can't see what's in it, and there's no digital version. So that is kind of a negative for me. So Hilary Grant is the author. She runs a knitwear company from Orkney, Scotland. And let me take a minute to show you the projects in it, because I really think this is a fantastic book. And the projects in it, she has all the techniques are explained and well illustrated. So that is good. And the projects are pretty simple. So they're good for a beginning stranded knitter. And they're all, the patterns are written with Shetland Spindrift. I think it's Shetland. Jameson's Shetland Spindrift. So the first pattern is the Beacon Palm Hat. And it's basically your simple hat. That's the first one. And I have a lot of this yarn too. The next pattern are basic ribbed mitts. And then, I know this is going to take a while, but because it's not on Ravelry, I think I should show you. We have this beautiful stranded hat. It's called Arrow Palm Hat. I know there's a pair of mitts to match that in here. They're cuffs, actually, but you could easily make them into mitts. Arrow cuffs. Next we have the dot dash cowl. And again, it's very simple but very beautiful. This one's knit in the round and then grafted. And here we have the barley fingerless mitts. Really nice. These are all great for gift giving because they would knit up real quick. Okay, here is the arrow circle scarf. So you have the hat, the mitts, and the scarf. And I believe this one is worked flat and then grafted together. So this is color work knit flat, which I've done before, but you have to be really careful with your tension when you're knitting color stranded work flat. I'll just put that out there. If I weren't used to doing this, I would consider just knitting a tube in the round following the stitch pattern. Just because it is, I mean, plus the other thing is the inside isn't, you'll see the inside of the scarf. I don't know. Here it is, full out on the woman. So, I don't know. All right, and then we have the barley twist headband, another adorable. This is great if you're a ponytail wearer. I know that's super popular lately. This is the Saxon hat. It has a very long brim. There's the pattern section. Another pair of cuffs with a very simple stranded knit pattern. Okay, these are really cool. I like these. And I might find some contrasting yarn and knit these. But these are called the Tied Mittens. I love how she played with the color there. I like that a lot. Barley Twist Cowl. So if you notice, the theme here, she'll have mittens, cowls, and hats with different stitch patterns all to go together. This is a really nice one. This is called the Loki hat. I like this. Again, it's just two colors throughout, and I like the way she kind of switches the predominance of the colors. bear with me because we're getting to some sweaters. Here's the Icelandic mittens. Very cute mittens. Here is the Tied Beret, and this would go with those other mittens that I liked. I think they were called the Dot and Dash mittens or something, where they had the plain color. This would go very well with that. And here's the Saxon mittens. You can see it here. And here is the Barley hat. I like that one a lot as well. Dot and Dash headband. Again, this is great for women who like to wear ponytails or buns on their head, which used to be me when my hair was long. But I like that one a lot. Here's just a little dickie. Very plain, very simple. Here is Wave Fingerless Mittens. I like these a lot. I might make these as well. I like them because they're long, but you can fold them over. I like that. Icelandic hat. A lot of accessories, but there are two sweater patterns in here. Loki circle scarf goes with that hat, right? And triangle gloves or mittens. So I saw these and I wanted to make them. And then I started thinking about it and I'm like, with hand knit mittens and gloves, what I can't stand is when it's windy, it just goes right through your knitted fabric. So I was thinking, what if I could knit something like this? And I should open this ahead of time, but I wish I could line it with like fleece or something like that. So I had this idea and I'm going to try it. I bought these basic fleece gloves and I am going to try, and this might be, presents for next year. I'm going to knit around the glove. And then I'm going to have a flap, and this will be like basically the lining for my mitten. What do you think? And then I'll give it to people for Christmas presents. It has the special thing so you could use it on your phone. And that's what I'm going to try and do. I might have to adjust the size of the patterns for these, but I think that would be great. Another scarf, wave circle scarf. Another beautiful pattern. And here are the sweaters now. This is the Icelandic sweater. And this is a nice first Icelandic sweater pattern. I've knit some of the really beautiful Icelandic yoke sweaters, and where sometimes you have 3 and 4 colors in the yoke at one time. This is a nicer place to start. And here's actually a much nicer picture of it. I don't know if I like it with the color work right in the middle. And for me, it's because I'm big chested and I don't want to draw the attention there. So I would not knit either one of these sweaters. Here's the Loki sweater. Again, because I don't like things that draw attention to the chest area. But, you know, for, I don't want to say normal size woman, but for a smaller busted woman, this would look really nice. So that's this book. I also got from him this, Drop Dead Easy Knits. This was pretty popular a while back. And one of the reasons I really wanted it was this and this. I'd like to make them both. We'll see if that happens. There's also a couple of really nice sweaters in here. Here it is right now. I opened up to it. This keynote sweater that I would like to make. And, you know, a couple of baby sweaters. There's just a lot of really good basic patterns in this book. So, added it to my library. Okay. I knew this was going to be long. I'm really sorry it's taking this long. So let me just show you my my new stash, and then I'll get to drawing the prizes for and talking about the senior love along. And if you don't care about the senior love along, you can just leave after you see my stash. Now, what I'm going to show you now, I actually got a while ago, and I forgot to show you, but it was during the Black Friday time that I took advantage of a sale. And this is called the Belladonna Shawl Set. It's superwash merino and a nylon blend. And each skein has 463 yards. It was sold as a pair for shawl knitting. And it is by Never Enough Time. And I bought them not just for the sale, but because I really love this color combination. And I had no idea this was coming, but my last, my November club yarn came from Highland Handmade. It is superwash merino cashmere nylon, around 350 yards. The colorway is called Hello, and she's calling the yarn Tupelo sock yarn. Came this, and by far my favorite color so far in the club is this one. It's based on a picture of a Todd Rundgren album cover called from Hello It's Me album, and look at how much it matches the yarn I had just picked out. So really, really thrilled with this. The other thing that I did during all the sales after and around Thanksgiving was I put out a wish list for Christmas, and I hinted that Spirit Trail Fiberwork was having a sale. I don't know if you recall, but she is getting rid of a line of fingering weight yarn, and she's getting rid of a base, and she had it all on sale for half off. So I my sister who picked my name was listening, and she got me everything on my wish list. She got me the yarn base that she's getting rid of is Tayet, and it's 100% superwash blueface Leicester. And here is the colorway Fairy Wood. It's a beautiful earthy green and woodsy colors. I went out of my comfort zone and got this color called Retro. I really, really like it, and I'm thinking about this, maybe making a sweater in this color. I'm thinking about it. I also got one of my favorite colorways from Spirit Trail Fiberwork, the Pink Sands colorway in Tayet. So these will be either socks or shawls. I also put some Sunna, which is another fingering weight base of hers, which is merino, cashmere, and silk. I put some of that up on my wish list, and my sister picked out two of those. They were on sale, but not half off. This is burnt caramel. I thought this would be a nice neutral to use in shawls. And this is one of her newer colorways called Echo. And it's like a... it reminds me of the 80s with the pastel-y colors, but in a beautiful sort of way. I am not an 80s person, but I really loved this color. I love the subtlety of the pastels that she's thrown in there, and I love that the base is like a blue-gray. So, yeah, I really like this. So those were all my Christmas presents. And without further ado, I just ended the podcast officially, and I was thinking about, because it was over an hour long, I'm going to break out the senior love along portion. And even if you didn't enter in the prize thread, listen to it. It's something I do every year for the seniors in the Veterans Nursing Home in Montrose, New York. And it really means a lot to them. So if you're not familiar with the senior love along, or you just want to hear how it went because you donated but didn't put on the prize list, I'll post that separately just on YouTube, and there'll be a link in the Ravelry group to it, and everyone will be notified via email of the prize they won. So that will just make this episode a little shorter, so I wanted to just post a goodbye. I'm going to wrap this up here, and I will see you all next year. I hope you all have a wonderful and safe new year, and let's look forward to 2017 with an open mind and with the intention that we're going to have a great year. And the next podcast will be next year, and it's going to be all about what I've done in 2016 and the goals for 2017. So start thinking about your knitting goals for next year, and I will see you next year. Bye-bye.